lecture here. We'll continue tomorrow. Thank you.
Jule, my name is Sriyandus. I am mathematics lecturer. So today our topic is inverse trigonometric function. Inverse trigonometric function. Before going to our topic, inverse trigonometric function, we will recapitulate some important points, which is very useful to understand our new topic, inverse trigonometric function. So, student, first, we have already studied about the trigonometric function in 11th class. So, at that time, we will define the trigonometric function graphically, and its domain and range is also discussed. Now, today, I will recapitulate the trigonometric function, and then we go to the inverse trigonometric function. Before going to inverse trigonometric function, we have to concept clear about the functions. So if you know the functions very well, then now we can go to then inverse trigonometric functions very clearly. Otherwise, it is very difficult. So, student, first, if you know the inverse function, then we can define the inverse trigonometric function clearly. Otherwise, it is very difficult if we go to direct the inverse trigonometric functions without the definition of inverse functions. So, first, I will recapitulate the inverse function. What is the inverse function? So I will here write the definition of inverse function. So what is the inverse function? So the inverse of a function is denoted as f, such that we will here write as a to b. Means when we put the input in this just here is just graphical representation in a small way. This is the A, we will take a set, just like here, 1, 2, 3, and another set, which is A, B, C. So, the function is nothing, but it is also a relation we have already studied in 11th class. So, if we sum put in here, we will take 1 in this set A, and we will apply a function. Means we will use a technique. So if we use a technique here, so 1 and it becomes A. Means just like here, you already know that the function. Function means we will know that just here. Okay. Very simple. So something we will input over here, for example, input over here. If we have a simply water here, so if we will put something here in this water, for example, what we call is salt. Yeah, another sugar. Anyway, you can take any other thing also. Then now this is change. The new product is the salty water. Salty water. Just see, our output is salty water. So same thing here. If we will put here, we will take here 1, and it change in the another. This we call it codomain. So this is our domain. This is our codomain. If we will put here, we will take 1, and if we apply the function, so there will be a changes, and it becomes A. So this is the most important we have to understand that. So what is the function? So function is nothing, but it is the relation between the codominant domain. which means we will put some input here, then the product will be here, new product will be here, so this will be the function.
As we will not worry about that. Now next is,
so the, now I will clear is f is a function from a to b. Means there is a relation between the elements of this domain to the codomain.
So we will already clear about this definition also. But
I will once again recapitulate this one, okay. Then the inverse of a function f is from a to b exist if it is 1-1 and onto. If it is 1-1 and onto. Okay, I will once again, what is mean by 1-1 and onto function? Okay, simply we have here domain and codomain. We will take a set for just for understanding this one. This is another set B. So for example, 1, 2, 3. So if every element of this domain has image found in the codomain, for example here A, which is the image of 1, and also the image of 2 is B, and also image of 3 is C, then this is the what we, this is the function of 1-1 and onto. In 1-1, every element in the domain has image in the codomain. And onto definition means every element in the codomain has only one image, yeah, only image in the domain. So this is what we call it, the 1-1 and onto. 1-1 means every element which have image in the codomain, and onto means every element in the codomain has pre-image in the domain. Now this is again I will clear you, okay. Now it is also called bijective, and so it is given by y equal to fx gives f inverse y equal to x. Very well, here if you don't understand, just see here. For example, if we will always take here x in the domain, and the, if we apply the function on the x, then just see here we will apply on the function, then this f is also applied on here x, so it becomes fx in here, fx in here codomain. So that's why it is also here, if we denote the x value in the domain, then we also, any element is also denoted as y in the codomain also. Now our here y becomes fx. So and y and fx are not different, these are same. It is depend upon our notation, just see. Otherwise, where is fx coming? And what is y? What is the relation between y and fx? So it is nothing, it is same. Just if we will here, just see, if we will here, just see. If we will take here x in the domain, and if we will apply the function here, then it becomes what? Fx, okay. So now just see, now instead of here you will find x fx equal to y. That means the image of x is y. Then just see, actually if we will apply the function here, x function x, then it becomes, you see here, y. So it is clear. Now here y equal to fx is clear. Now we can find the inverse. Then here we write as f inverse y equal to x. So how it is coming? Just see, you have y equal to fx. Yeah, fx equal to y we have here. Just see y equal to fx. Okay. So if I will this function, we will take here, then it becomes inverse, f inverse y equal to x. This is what the inverse function. What the inverse function? I will explain once again to understand our inverse trigonometric function very clearly. So then here, one of the most important thing is inverse trigonometric function is exist or applicable where we have only bijective function, one and on two. In 11th class, we will only studied about this trigonometric function where we didn't get the one and on two. That's why now here we will restrict to the domain and range in such a way that there exists inverse trigonometric function. Otherwise, what happened, just see, in 11th class, for example, we will discuss about the sine theta, then we have, it have many one function. Just see, here, -1, -1. Just see. If we will discuss about the y equal to sine x. So if we will take here 0, so the sine 0 will be 0. Similarly, then we will discuss about the pi by 2. If we take pi by 2 sine 90 degree, then it becomes 1. So then sine pi. Pi is equal to just 0. Okay. Now similarly, we will take here -3π/2. Now I will represent with the help of chart. So I will introduce the next chart. Before going to next chart, I will just remind about the next one. Just see, this is our function from A to B, just like this one. And this is our inverse. Inverse means B to A. Actually, we will write A to B. This is our domain and this is our range. Now it will change. Now this become our domain and it's become range. Now if we will write in different direction, then we will never see such this one function. So we will always denote it as this direction. So here left to right direction. That's why I will change it here. B to A means I will write here B and then A. So this is our inverse denoted by B to A. A to B, inverse is B to A. So I will here write F inverse equal to B to A. So here, f is a function from a to b such that fx equal to y. This is our function. So now here, inverse is, we will write g. Instead of f inverse, we will write g. Here, instead of a inverse, we will write g also. So g is a function from b to a. G is a function from b to a such that gy equal to x, gy equal to x, g is also write it as f inverse y equal to x. So now here if we will discuss about the sine theta. For example here, if f is a function from a to b such that fx equal to sine x, which is also denoted by y, I already explained you. Now here same thing, g is a function from b to a such that gy equals to x. And if we will discuss about the inverse, then here is the only trigonometric function, sine x. Now here we will write sine inverse x. So sine inverse y. So here we will discuss about the inverse function. That's why I will here
I will write here, sign inverse y. So now here I will explain something more about the trigonometric functions. Now here sine, the function from real domain means this is our domain, so it is real R to our range is -1 to 1, -1 and 1. So I will explain in the next chart. Similarly, cos real number to this interval -1 to 1, close interval -1 to 1. Similarly, tan, cot, sec, cosec. Also, we will discuss about the sine inverse also. So just here, first we will discuss about this only sine function. Okay. So then you will understand cos and tan, cot, sec, and cosec as it is. So what is the sine in the domain? Here we can take real numbers and its range. So the is only lies between -1 and 1. We will also discuss in we were also discussing 11th class. So now I will introduce a chart for this also, how to define the sine inverse graphically. So the representation of sine inverse through next chart. Now I will here show you graph of inverse function. So the function is from x to y such that fx equal to y sine x, which we studied in 11th class. So at that time we will show in this way here. So we will take the values of the sine angles here, 0, 90 degree, 180 degree, 270 degree, and similarly we will take the negative values of here. So what is its range value? What is the value of sine 0 degree, 0, sine 90 degree, 1, sine pi, 0, sine 3 pi by 2, -1. Similarly, same as we go to here, negative values. So what were the graph of this sine function? We will just see. When we take the 0, then the value also sine 0 is 0. So here we will take the 0, then the sine 0 is also 0. Then we go to sine 30 degree. Then we will increase sine 30 degree. Sine 30 degree, then sine 45 degree, then sine 60 degree, then sine 90 degree. Okay, we will increasing our values. Sine 30 degree 1 by 2, then 1 by under root 2, sine 45, sine 60 under root 3 by 2, then 1. Then here we will increasing, means the function is increasing. So increasing up to 1 here. Then now next, after 90 degree, then it will decreasing, means decreasing from 1 to, and then we go to here, then decreasing up to reach back to 0 degree. Here if we will write sine 0 degree is 0, then just see we will increasing here 0, here 0.5, and so on, increasing up to 1. Now we will back, then it will decreasing 1 to 0. So our graph is decreasing. Here I will show you decreasing. So sine pi means sine 180 degree, it also becomes 0. So and so on. Similarly, if we take the negative values, then same thing. It is also just see decreasing, decreasing, then increasing, increasing. Okay, so same thing. So we were already started in 11th class. Now I will once again explain you. Then here just see, you have 0 degree 0, sine pi 0, sine minus pi 0. Similarly pi by 2, 1, and minus 3 pi by 2, 1, 3 pi by 2, minus 1, similarly, minus pi by 2, minus 1. So, here, now, this domain and range will be restricted in between here, we will take the value of 0, just see. Here, the values gone from, yeah, starting from 0, yeah, 1 to minus 1. 1 to minus 1. So we will only 3 values are there. Sine 0 is 0. Then similarly, we take only 3 values. So then just see pi by 2 is 1. Then minus pi by 2 is minus 1. Then we have only restricted the domain and range between pi by 2 to minus pi by 1 to minus 1. So this is our function, which is 1, 1 and on 2. Otherwise, it will be many one function. Just see. Okay, this one is many one function. If we will just see, we will three values only, write three values, minus 1, 0, 1. Here only we have three values. Then now here we will take 0 degree is 0. Similarly, 0 degree is 0. Then pi degree is also 0. Pi degree is also 0. Then pi by 2, sine pi by 2 is 1. So similarly, we will take here minus pi by 2, minus 1, minus pi by the image of minus pi by 2 is minus 1. Okay. Similarly, if we go to the minus pi, then the value is, the image is 0. Now this is our many one function. Many one function. So at that time, here inverse does not exist. So we have to restrict the value. We do not take all the values in the domain. So we have to take only three values. Yeah, between only pi 2, we can take only pi 2, pi by 2. And we will take only restrictive values between pi by 2 and minus pi by 2. So the range value will be also restricted from minus 1 to 1. So that's why our inverse when exists when the function is 1, 1 and on 2. That's why I will here explain here, let F inverse equal to G. F inverse is also right as G, such that Y is from, and the function is, G is the function from Y to X. Such that GY equal to X, and we will write as sine inverse Y. And from here, I write here the graph. So I will change it. Why? Just see, here we take Y equal to sine X. Now, same thing, I will here write Y equal to sine inverse X. So just for understanding, for better understanding, I will write here sine. Just see, here, this is the function simply from pi by 2 to 1 and 0 to 1 and minus pi by 2 1. This is the function, this is the domain, and this is the range. So here y equal to sine x, which is bijective. Now we will change the inverse means this to this one. Okay, change from this to this, y to x. That's why here, now change here, the range will be changed as domain 1, 0, minus 1, 1, 0, minus 1, and the codomain will be go to pi by 2, 0, minus pi by 2. This is our y equal to sine inverse x, and just see, first, our sine function, the graph is on the x-axis. Now, if we will take the inverse, then there is only two axes, one is x-axis, then another will be y-axis. This is the what?
the reciprocal, what we call it, inverse of sine inverse function. That means first sine inverse is lie on the x-axis, then its inverse is lie on the y-axis. Then I will write here y equal to sine inverse x. So now we will close the today's topic here, and tomorrow we will come to the new topic. Thank you.